Indian textile value chain with the global demand. Now, you know, this is something which is often touted, and touted for good reason, as a big plus point or a big unique proposition that India has, which is where very few countries, whether it is Sri Lanka or Bangladesh or Vietnam, can compare with, and that is the presence of a complete value chain in India. Having said that, for a variety of reasons, and I hope our panelists will throw some more light on that today, we are yet to realize our full potential as a supplier to the global markets. Various challenges. The Secretary of Textile earlier today talked about fragmentation or low value addition, just copycat techniques of, you know, trying to do the same what, say, a neighbor like Bangladesh is doing, or infrastructural issues like high interest cost or logistics or transportation or high transaction cost in India. So in spite of having a complete value chain, we have not been able to leverage that. At the same time, if you look at it from an external macro point of view, the world textile market is getting consolidated. China is the number one contributor with a 31% share of the total world's textile and apparel exports. India is number two, but there's a big difference, there's a big distance between number one and number two, where from 31% of China, India comes down to 5% in 2018. The good news is that, be it because of increasing costs or inflation or the US-China trade issues or just by central diktat, China is gradually ceding its dominance, and that market share is up for grabs. The bad news is that, particularly in the apparel front, and I think also in the textile front, India so far has not managed to take up the $30 or $40 billion of business which has exited China in the last 4 or 5 years. Other countries like Bangladesh, Vietnam, have taken the most advantage of this opportunity. On the apparel front, particularly Bangladesh and Vietnam have become the most sought after destinations in recent years for major international brands and retailers. And we heard today in the morning that even Indian retailers, and the country manager of Marks and Spencer was here bemoaning the fact that even though she would like to buy more from within India for the Indian market, the constraints of cost and economics just make it much more worthwhile for her to import goods. India has not yet been able to tap this opportunity, and apparel exports, particularly in India, have stagnated in the last 2 years. So it's a double-edged sword right now. There is a terrific opportunity as China continues to exit the market, but at least our recent track record has not been great. And even though we have a completely integrated value chain, India has not made much headway. What can we do to change this narrative going forward is something which our panelists here will talk about. Now, we are going to work on the following focus areas for discussion. Number one, try to understand the international buyer's perspective. Two, talk about India's competitiveness in the global market. Three, how well is India diversified in new and innovative products? Four, how well have we explored new market opportunities or enhanced market share in existing markets? Five, and this is something we talked a lot about in the morning, what is the role of trade agreements in enhancing India's ability to penetrate new markets? And finally, we've talked about the fragmented scale of India manufacturing. How can India focus on economies of scale in manufacturing? Let me start with the first, the international buyer's perspective. A few sub-questions come up, and I'm going to throw it over to the panel for talking about it. First, what is the current international buyer's perspective in working with India? How has it changed over the years? We hear that big buyers want to say the same commodity garment at a lower price every year, with the increasing costs of raw material and other costs, how can suppliers cater to such demand? May I address this question to Shreyaskar, who Shreyaskar has the big advantage of being a completely vertical player in the knitted garments field, because they do their own spinning, knitting, processing and garmenting, and in fact they've even gone backward and are directly into coordinating with farmers for organic cotton. And they do a lot of exports, so he's in touch with a number of international players. So Shreyaskar, your perspective on understanding the international buyer's perspective vis-a-vis India.
Thanks, Gautam. I would just reiterate what we were speaking this morning on. We had an American Chamber of Commerce visit a few months back. What they clearly spelled out was that we should not be asking them what are the solutions that they need for us to be providing. They want us to be understanding their problem and resolving that. First and foremost is the scale that is needed, that is still lacking. And when we talk about exports, we are so fragmented, we are not yet ready. We have truly created economies of scale, world-class manufacturing from our home textiles, Terry Towel perspective. We are the largest manufacturer in the world as a nation. We haven't managed to do that. And as the secretary was mentioning, only we have less than 10 companies in apparel with 1,000 crores or plus. So what is it that we need to be doing to create that scale? And there are only two textile parks worth of repute that can be mentioned right now, one of which is still under construction. So we have to create that scale. Even before scale, price, quality, delivery is a given as far as customers are concerned. What is it? And we're talking about resurgent India, and as the Honorable Minister mentioned, what can we be proud of? What is it that we need to be selling to our customers that is already an established strength of the country? In that I can say, yes, price, quality, delivery is something that is needed, is a given. But we have customers here who at this point in time are already paying 15% premium over and above the cotton prices to the farmers. In the last 1 year, we have invested through fair trade over 2.5 crore rupees giving to our employees washing machines, fridge, all of that. So the brands are associating with us in ensuring that the living wages are provided to the employees. They work with us. For that, how can we really take up responsible manufacturing collectively when it comes to employee welfare beyond just the compliances? And India has that strength. That is something that is ingrained in us. We just need to leverage that. We've been talking about Coimbatore being a base where ZLD is already there. Renewable energy is already practiced completely. We have 1700 megawatts installed there in the apparel trade. So how can we really take that forward in bringing? And this is what the customers are needing today. Sustainable Apparel Coalition collectively with over $1 trillion worth of retail committed to sustainable manufacturing. That is something that they are now, that is no more a trend. It is also the norm, and we have not capitalized on it yet, but we have that strength as a nation we can work on. From a quality perspective, I can mention, we have a long way to go. We recently started working on the CII cluster program manufacturing excellence, working ourselves along with some other companies within Madhya Pradesh on the manufacturing excellence. And the first thing that we do is 5S, sorting out what is not needed, having things where they are supposed to be doing. And we found bearings that have been lying with over 10 years. So we don't even take stock of the assets that
same question to Mr. Sharma. Again, a veteran in the textile industry, and the specific question being that whether it is apparel or textile, Shreyaskar talked about a, I would say, a fairly unique situation where somebody is prepared to pay a premium to buy a particular product out of India. That may be a niche product, but for the regular products where we want to compete with countries like Vietnam or Bangladesh or China for that matter. How can we be competitive and how can we cater to customers who, if they want to buy the same thing, want to be able to reduce price season after season?
Let me take a minute to put the perspective of competitiveness of the Indian textile value chain in place. Conceptually, it is true, and it has been studied by the researchers in management, that the development of any country's GDP is directly linked with development of its exports and is more relevant to the developing economies. And therefore, unfortunately, we have not been able to take that advantage in spite of the fact that India is an integrated textile value chain supplier, right from fibers, whether it's cotton or it's man-made, and going up to the apparel and garment manufacturing. So somewhere there, the issue of competitiveness is coming into our way that we have not been able to expand. So one of the major issue here, just again conceptually building on this, that if a nation's, the economic, the GDP is below up to 2000 levels, the export and the development of export of particularly textile industry, textile value chain is more important. And once it goes beyond that, and that's the experience of China, that has been the experience of South Korea first, China later, and that an integrated textile in any industry, in any country, makes that advantage. Unfortunately, in our case, that we have not been able to take the advantage of export into the textile items, because the textile has been basically like yarn and fabric. Today, yarn capacity, spinning capacity is almost 35-1/3 of spinning is just flying item. Capacity has been created, investment has been there. But there are some areas of competitiveness is coming. Fabric, of course, there are very limited suppliers of that which can meet the requirement of the global, the customers of the various brands. And those who have to compete is the normal, like Gautam says, the normal material which we are able to get from here, like yarns and fabrics. Yarn for the knits and fabric for the apparel industry as a part of the value chain. And one of the major issues which is coming in the way is in terms of the embedded taxation, which is about the value chain. And we have been requesting the government that at least for the purpose of exports, as far as the apparel made up export is concerned, it is taken care, because partially it has been addressed earlier, but with the kind of legislation coming now, which WTO issues, Mr. Vishwanath is touching that. I think we need to see that we make the tax neutrality at least for the export value chain. And how we get that is for the government to make the mechanism that once if production is targeted towards export, whether directly or indirectly, how do you really get that issue addressed, that we are not passing on the taxes in the manufacturing and making it the value chain. The second is in terms of developing more exports, even in the apparel, I would also put up a flag the issue of that how do you attract the entrepreneurship numbers more into the apparel manufacturing. You know, we have a spread over all the textile industries, like for spinning as well as for the fabric of course, because this can be still transported. But our apparel manufacturing, the major export is centered in hubs like NCR in Bangalore, and and there are partially in Tripura and Ludhiana, that's for the knit sector based. But I think we have to see that how do we make our manufacturing of the apparel also more competitive, where the global brands, they come to us and we have adequate entrepreneurship and supply source available for that. And that's a macro issue in terms of deciding on the textile policies, both in terms of location and attracting the investment and bringing more and more entrepreneurship. With the cost in China going up, I think we, this is the area where we can at least impress upon them that apart from their investments in countries like Bangladesh and Vietnam, how can certain parts of India will still be more competitive if they put in the investment? Garmenting, as I understand, may not require that intense investment, but I think it requires basically the soft know-how of apparel manufacturing and supply chain in the world market. That's my point.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Just if I were to sum up the two comments made so far on competitiveness of India from the international buyer's perspective, I completely agree with what Mr. D.L. Sharma said, that apparel industry in India, historically, there were reasons why historically it came up around particular production centers, mainly urban areas. But by the same reason, we need to move outside these urban areas, because these urban areas are just not cost competitive. We need, for the first time we are seeing in India, in the last 5 years or so, this spirit of competitive federalism from amongst the different state governments who are literally vying with each other to offer better, more competitive policies. Specifically, almost every state government has a special policy for the textile and apparel sector, and the main reason is they need to create employment, and they are offering good benefits to create that employment. So I think our manufacturers, one way of being competitive is to take on, is to move into these markets and use the fact that you'll be a pioneer in those markets, you know, that brings its own set of problems. But it also can bring a certain set of advantages, that not only you can get the benefits of what the state government is offering, but also to Shreyaskar's point, that, you know, when you have to, you know, I think Shreyaskar will vouchsafe, as I can vouchsafe, that when you try to bring new methods of manufacturing into a 20 or 30 year old setup, unlearning is more difficult than learning a new thing. So when you go to a new area and you're starting from scratch, it's often more advantageous, and you can piggyback into newer systems of working, and if you do it well, you can probably organize a more competitive way of doing it. Let me move to the next point of being competitive in the local market. I want to ask this question to Mr. Ravindra Singh. That while India has some of the biggest exporters in home textiles, why are we unable to replicate that success in apparel and be as competitive in apparel as we have been in home textile with countries like China, Bangladesh or Vietnam? In other words, why are we, as our secretary textile said today, that why in this huge country like ours, which we pride ourselves on entrepreneurship, why do we have only maybe 10 companies in the entire textile chain which have a turnover of more than, or an export of more than 1,000 crores? So what is it that lacks in apparel which is there in home textiles?
I think I'm going to talk more about solutions. I think the problem seems to be very apparent. But just one historical perspective. Go back into the history of textile and clothing. Go back into the late 80s, early 90s. There was a major change which was taking place. Korea, Taiwan, slightly earlier Japan, Hong Kong lost their competitiveness. And the biggest beneficiary was China. And the reason why China today is covering A to Z of textile is simply because they got tremendous amount of import coming from Korea, Taiwan, Japan. That was the starting point, and China kept building up on that. So it's the problem, jo samasya hai, wo bahut gambhir hai. Hum log jo hai, essentially spring summer country hai. Hamare paas limited amount of clothing hai jo hum offer kar sakte hain international market mein. Aur dusri samasya ye hai ki jahan tak bilateral treaties hain, wahan pe humko bahut bada disadvantage hai. Now, samasya ka hal kya ho sakta hai? I mean, let's talk about solutions. Dekhiye, Shreyaskar ne ek baat kahi ki pricing, quality and delivery is taken for granted. To bacha kya? Service. is there a possibility ki hum as a nation service mein aage badh sakte hain? Aur iska main aapko ek keval ek solution deta hu jo Shreskar ko bhi malum hai, unhone bhi dekha hai. It is very very important to be close to the customer. हम लोगों ने जॉइंटली एक कंपनी देखी थी पुर्तगाल में, जो 2002 में जिसने शुरुआत करी, और उसने 2002 से लेके करीब 2012 में 100 मिलियन यूरो का टर्नओवर बिल्ड किया. अब आप ये देखिए कि एक ऐसी कंट्री जहाँ पे लेबर कॉस्ट बहुत हाई है, पर वो फिर भी ग्रो करती गई और हर साल 15% ग्रो करी. उसका कारण यही था कि वो ज़ारा के इंडिटेक्स के ऑफिस में 24/7 बैठते थे. उनके पास करीब 11-12 लोग हैं जो अपने ऑफिस में बैठने के बजाय वो इंडिटेक्स के ऑफिस में बैठे हैं, प्रोडक्ट डेवलप कर रहे हैं, सैंपलिंग जो है 24 घंटे में कर रहे हैं. एक इस समस्या का जो हल है ये है कि मेरे ख्याल से जो गारमेंटिंग कंपनीज हैं, दे हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी क्लोज टू द कस्टमर. उनके घर के अंदर घुस के प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट टीम का पार्ट बन जाए, क्योंकि जो प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट का जो प्रोसेस होता है वो डिटरमिन करता है कि वो गारमेंट कहाँ बनेगा. तो 40% हम कहते हैं कि क्विक रिस्पॉन्स मार्केट है, उसको आप कंट्रोल करिए, यू विल गेट बेटर कंट्रोल ओवर जो लॉन्गर डिलीवरीज का है. क्योंकि हो सकता है आप ये डिसाइड करेंगे कि वो गारमेंट इंडिया में बनेगा या बांग्लादेश में बनेगा. तो यू हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी क्लोज टू योर कस्टमर. विद मीडियम साइज गारमेंटर्स नीड टू लुक एट setting up companies close to the customer. Interaction should be 24/7. चाहे वो यूरोपियन मार्केट है, अमेरिका में हम देख रहे हैं. एक छोटा सा मैं आपको एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ. एक शिकागो में हम लोग कंपनी बना रहे हैं किसी के लिए, और इसलिए बना रहे हैं शिकागो में कंपनी क्योंकि मैं अपने कस्टमर को चॉइस देना चाहता हूँ कि वो अगर उसको कोई गारमेंट क्विकली चाहिए या वो चाहता है कि फैब्रिक मेड इन अमेरिका यूज हो, तो हम वो कोटा वाले में बनाएंगे. बट वो बिजनेस जो है वो ड्राइव करेगा हमारा लॉन्ग टर्म बिजनेस को भी. जहां पे हमारे हमको कॉस्ट कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस की जरूरत है वो हम हिंदुस्तान में बनाएंगे, लेकिन हम ब्लॉक करेंगे कि जो कस्टमर का जो फ्रंट होगा वो हम होंगे. तो दैट इज द रीजन यू हैव टू बी एक्सट्रीमली क्लोज टू योर कस्टमर, क्लोज टू द मार्केट, एंड यू हैव टू बी द नंबर वन सर्विस प्रोवाइडर. ये एक आपकी जो समस्या है उसका हल है. दूसरी चीज ये है कि वी हैव टू क्रिएट कैपेसिटीज, और दिस इनिशिएटिव हैज टू बी टेकन स्पेशली इन द सिंथेटिक साइड ऑफ द बिजनेस, चाहे वो पॉलिएस्टर है चाहे पॉलीएमाइड है. आई थिंक दैट इज एन एरिया जो काफी इस समय ओपन है, जहां पे वी डोंट हैव टू कम्पीट विद बांग्लादेश, एटलीस्ट ऑन द शॉर्ट टर्म. लॉन्ग टर्म पे हम कह नहीं सकते, लेकिन शॉर्ट टर्म पे यू डोंट हैव टू कम्पीट विद बांग्लादेश और वियतनाम. Now that capacity has to be created by the large textile companies, chahe wo polyester, polyamide hai, knitted side or the woven side. Jo downstream hai, Indian garmenting industry sufficiently evolved hai ki usko wo convert kar sakti hai. But jo sabse badi samasya hai garmenting industry ke aage wo ye hai ki usko raw material hi milta, wo China jata hai ya Thailand jata hai to get the raw material, and that is not the way you can be competitive or aap delivery mein लोगों के साथ कंपीट कर सकेंगे. एक बात और कहूंगा कि शायद आपको अनुमान नहीं है कि लॉट ऑफ स्मॉल एंटरप्रेन्योर्स यूरोप में, यूएसए में, इन लॉट्स ऑफ वेज दे कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू, बिकॉज उनकी अपनी समस्या ये है कि उनके पास मैनेजमेंट बैंडविड्थ बड़ी छोटी है, फाइनेंशियल बैंडविड्थ भी बहुत छोटी है. तो जब आप उनको अप्रोच करते हैं कि भाई हम आपके साथ पार्टनरशिप कर लेंगे और लेट अस क्रिएट एन एंटिटी इन यूरोप और अमेरिका, दे आर मोर देन हैप्पी, दे विल स्टे विद यू एंड दे विल प्रोवाइड सर्टेन एट्रीब्यूट्स जो आपकी स्ट्रेंथ को कॉम्प्लीमेंट करेंगे. तो मेरे ख्याल आपको समस्या का हल ढूंढना चाहिए, क्योंकि देखिए जहां तक कॉस्ट कटिंग है, बिकमिंग मोर प्रोडक्टिव एसेक्टर, दिस इज समथिंग विच द क्लोथिंग इंडस्ट्री इन इंडिया कैन मैनेज ब्यूटिफुली. बट थोड़ी सी आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स थिंकिंग रखिए कि सर्विस का एलिमेंट, ब्रिंग अ ह्यूज एलिमेंट ऑफ सर्विस सो दैट योर कस्टमर्स आर कंप्लीटली वेडेड टू यू. यू बिकम एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट एंड टू अ सर्टेन एक्सटेंट आप डिटरमिन कर रहे हैं. सपोज कीजिए कोई चीज बांग्लादेश में बनेगी, हो सकता है कि फैब्रिक सोर्सिंग आप डिटरमिन करेंगे. तो कहीं ना कहीं इंडियन textile industry ka badhotri hogi isse.
Thank you, Ravinder. I don't want to let you get away so easily. Specifically, why have we been competitive in home textiles? And why can't we do the same thing in apparel? Jahan service ki baat hai, it should apply equally to two different industry groups dealing with largely the same kind of customer segment. हम ये क्या कारण है कि जो हम टेक्सटाइल जो होम टेक्सटाइल जो हम कर सके वो हम अपैरल में नहीं कर पा रहे
Yeah, I think Gautam, I think the issue, if you go back into the home textile, history of home textile, generally in home textile, the investments are very large. These are not small investments. You look at white bed bed sheeting, you look at terry towel, these are large investments, and this is probably one of the reason why Bangladesh has not taken a major position. There is a position which Bangladesh has taken. Agar aap jo competitiveness ki baat kar rahe hain, it is simply that those capacities don't exist in Bangladesh, those capacities don't exist in Vietnam. The day those capacities get created, we are going to have an issue. But right now, jo hamara sabse bada barrier ban gaya hai, wo capital cost ka hai. Chahe wo Trident Group hai, chahe Wellspun hai, अगर आप कैपेसिटीज देखेंगे उनकी इकोनॉमीज ऑफ स्केल देखेंगे यू नो दे कैन टेक ऑन एनी वन इन द वर्ल्ड आई डोंट नो वेदर दैट कैपिटल मोबिलाइजेशन इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन बांग्लादेश इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन वियतनाम आई डोंट नो आई रिफ्यूज टू बिलीव दैट बांग्लादेश इफ दे हैड द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ कैपिटल मोबिलाइजेशन दे वुडंट बी एज कॉम्पिटिटिव इट इज सिंपली दैट दोज कैपेसिटीज डोंट एग्जिस्ट एंड जहां पे कैपिटल कैन बी अ बैरियर I think we are going to do well. जैसे Reliance के केस में polyester yarn, polyester staple fiber में the biggest barrier is capital investment. अगर आपके पास economies of scale नहीं है आप global market में compete नहीं कर पाएंगे तो I think Gautam इसका major reason ये है कि आज की तारीख में home textile में capital barriers हैं हो सकता है कि आज से 10 साल के बाद capital mobilization is possible.
Again, By that same token, the capital barrier restricts investment in new capacity because it's a highly capital intensive industry. That barrier does not apply to apparel because it does not require so much capital to build up apparel capacity. Are you therefore saying that if we can work out, perhaps in collaboration with government, some way of setting up what the government is calling mega clusters, which will enable competitive manufacturing of scale? Is that the way to go for Indian industry going forward?
Yes, that is definitely one of the solution. But I'm saying something a little more than that, Gautam.
Is that true?
Yes. I mean, absolutely. I agree with you that if we can create these extremely competitive textile parks, that is going to complement the element of service. But I'm a great believer that if India ke liye jo ki USP honi chahiye, wo service honi chahiye, aur service hone ke liye You have to be very close to your customer. जब तक you have to become one with your customer. If you become one with your customer is vetted and कहीं ना कहीं that decision making process कि ये garment कहाँ बनेगा, fabric किससे खरीदा जाएगा, उसमें आपका योगदान हो जाएगा. And the moment you are also a contributor to that decision making, I think कहीं ना कहीं अगर मान ले गारमेंट वो इंडिया में नहीं बना बांग्लादेश में बना हो सकता फैब्रिक वर्धमान से जाएगा या नाहर से जाएगा या अरविंद से जाएगा तो हमें उस एंड को ब्लॉक करना जरूरी है कि जहां पे कस्टमर हमें इतनी ट्रस्ट पैदा कस्टमर में हम इतना ट्रस्ट पैदा करते हैं कि हम लोग मास्टर्स हैं प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट में और जो हमने आपको उदाहरण दिया कि देयर इज अ गारमेंट इंपोर्टेबल ग्रुप डिस्पाइट द फैक्ट दैट द लेबर कॉस्ट वाज सो अनकॉम्पिटिटिव Only because of service, वो zero से 100 पहुंच गया और ऐसे बहुत सारे partners हैं, वो are more than happy because जो आप उनको offer करते हैं, that complements what he has. And this is not only true about Europe, it's also true about America.
Very, very interesting learning there, because if you look at what attracts a brand or an importer to India. One of the points which will be upfront, which will be high up on the agenda, is our capacity for product development. Generally speaking, India does apparel business ki baat kar raha hu. India does a better job on product development than most other competing countries, particularly when you take Bangladesh or Vietnam, which is today being so much compared, we are generally better than them. If we can complement that better product development with better service, as Ravindra is saying, that could be at least one of the winning combinations, or at least for one segment of our industry.